25. I was married about 1 year, and I was working in Albion Motors. We were living in what was Victoria Drive West in Renfrew, which was a single end, if anybody knows what that was. And life was good.
I stayed down in Notcher Street. That's where I stayed, me and my wife. 19 Notcher Street. One up. There's only six in the building. That's the way it was.
I was in the boys' brigade in the North Church, and we decided to run a bus to the cup final for when the Renfrew Juniors were playing there. So it was a busload of us all went. Some of the boys, some of their parents, friends, a good full busload all went up to Hampden.
I was a centre forward, yeah. I'm the highest goal scorer in Renfrew. Renfrew Juniors. Nathie's beat my record yet. Has it been 60 odd goals I've scored?
But maybe one of the reasons why so many has wanted to go was because of Jimmy and Robert Connolly, who was a goalkeeper, both played for the third Renfrew BB company before they went to the juniors. So that was a kind of impulse to follow. And so it was good to see them there.
We're playing no bad. This is the way the game was, but Hampden's a big, big, big park. Do you know what I mean? Didn't realise how it was. But we were playing no bad, and etc. But they're all probably were playing no bad and all, and everything was all fine. We scored and made it one, and then they scored in the second half, I think it was. That made it one each, so the next game was on the Wednesday. So we went up on the Wednesday, and they won 1-0. But we were awfully unlucky, but we never won that day, that night.
Nettie at that time was an officer in the Lifeboys, as it was then. So she went as well. She had a scarf, which was, as far as I know, an India tire scarf, which was, I think, black, red and yellow. And of course, Rob Roy played in black and red. And we were in the stand, would you believe? And there was all these Renfrew Junior supporters with their blue and white scarves, and my wife sitting in the middle of them were red and black and yellow scarf. So it wasn't flavour of the month.
After we had our meals, we all went up the stairs, and all it was busy, and they were all giving us a big cheer, and we were all dancing. Then we all come back out again, and ended up in the Wallace Bar. The Wallace Bar, was it? Aye. Then after that, just went home. The wife was in the house anyway herself, like, you know.
Well, there we go, we're on the move. That's him coming out there, Robert Connolly, anyway. Where's Jimmy Rundell? Could be there somewhere, Jimmy.
Mm-hmm. Billy.
Who was that?
Billy. Is that captain?
All right, so it's your team captain, all right. Is that your manager, Jimmy? No, that must be Rob Roy. Well, the start of the show, that was a big stand. We were in that. We were in the stand. I don't know. Can't remember booking tickets or in. I don't remember it looking empty, if you know.
Just that part of the park was empty. I can't remember that.
The secluded bit or cut off bits of it. That's your goal, Jimmy.
I know.
That's your goal. Jordy Newton, where is he?
Oh, the Renfrew supporters.
Looks like it, aye. Well, we were there on the Wednesday as well. You didn't score a goal, so we came home disappointed. That was your fault.
I know. Can you score goals all the time?
No. I think they were well renowned in the junior football at that time, the Rob Roy.
Aye.
And we were up in that stand somewhere.
Uh-huh. My mother and my father and a whole lot of them were up.
Oh, aye, the whole gang would be there, I'm sure.
A whole lot of them.
See, when you look at that in Hampden, you know, if you're in the front there, you're quite low down. If you're as a spectator.
Oh, aye.
In Old Hampden. I don't know, I wonder what band was there, I don't know. Yeah, it's the Renfrew Worthies.
Well, you saw them, there's only one guy I knew.
What are they?
All the ones.
All oh, right, the councillors.
Only one of you. Didn't know any of the ones. You'll see him come round in a minute. Maybe he was standing here or something.
I think that's maybe John Young.
Everything with.
That's Jack Mason, is it?
Aye.
Aye, that's right. All these folk living in Renfrew, I mean, it's only half the size as it is now.
Aye. Look at that, yeah. Big support that day.
Oh, aye, lots of folk. That's them waiting in a bus coming back, I presume.
Aye.
Well, that'd be there coming down the road.
Aye. And the bus.
Aye.
That's it.
You up on the stage there?
Aye. The tune hall.
Aye. You're all well dressed, Jimmy.
Oh, aye.
They must have been paying you too much money. Mm-hmm. There's Francie.
Aye.
He was a character, it was Francie. There's George Newton there. The man that scored the goal. That's probably the only time I've ever seen Francie with a suit on.
Aye. Did you take him up to the dancing?
Aye. Enough, man.
You know, that's where we were getting our thing, wasn't it, you know?
Aye.
And the supporters.
Aye. And the madmen.
Aye. Well, see, you know, one relation of Francie's.
Is he?
Aye.
It was a big family with them.
I know.
Aye. Francie Bogey.
Aye. There's about 60,000 there last Saturday. I mean, that was a good crowd, you know. Aye, and we all got 100 quid. And the next minute, the tax people got us. And they took 40 quid off us.
I think on an occasion like that, it is an up time, if you like. Everybody's on top of the world. Juniors have done well. And in our lifetime, it never happened before, so it was a good thing. And I think it was a general feeling around the town that folk were quite happy about this situation. Aye, it was good.
Somebody was trying to get me to take a game on. I said, wait a minute. Yeah, I won. But now, you know, the team's not playing very well now. They want me to come play in the team. I said, wait, joking. It's 84. You want me to come in the 84?